What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Today we're having a look at an HP 5750, and it is its 8th birthday from being in production. Not only just production, but being on the floor in production. Let's have a look at this thing, and let's go through the history. Let's talk a little bit about it. So again, 8 years old, it owes us nothing. This thing has been around so long. Dual core, I should say, dual core system. Let's get into it. Dual core system. Unfortunately, the only problem that we have had with the 5750 is this. This piece, you get a, of course, you get your CPU underneath it, and over top of it, you get the aluminum. You get the aluminum heatsink. But unfortunately, let's see if I can get in here. It is mounted with plastic. That is just plastic, and it's right into the board. And the thing is that there's also a spring in there. And if you get enough heat and enough oil on this thing, we have had so many go just because, maybe you can see it, I'm hoping you can, right here, it just snaps. So this whole piece comes off, meaning that the heat sink comes off, meaning that it's basically useless to us at that point. But this thing's been through some real bad stuff, and it keeps ticking. This is about the first HP Compact system that has come out. The first HP Compact system to come out as soon as HP bought Compact, just before it went down the shitter, just before it took a dump. And we also have DC5850, and you want those because they have metal. This is all metal in the 5850s. Definitely get a 5850 if you're going to buy them for like $5 each. But seriously, 8th birthday, doing pretty good. Doing pretty good. We got multiples that haven't lasted this long, but I swear to God, this is the last time that HP actually looked good. So check it out. Dual core. Have a good one, folks. Catch you later.